Hello everyone. Welcome to Food Tech Network. If you haven't subscribed our YouTube channel yet, then subscribe it now and don't forget to click on the bell icon. For regular updates, visit our website www.foodtechnetwork.in and join our groups. We share jobs, webinars, quizzes, trainings, news on daily basis. We never charge any consultancy fee for jobs.
Okay, so our today's topic is preservation by high temperature. In this lecture, we will learn about how can we preserve our food by applying high temperature. Okay, so preservation by high temperature is one of the most ancient method. Okay, do you know pasteurization is one of the most prominent method of high temperature? Okay, pasteurization was invented in 1862. This preservation method is okay. So how can we preserve our food by high temperature? Is like by applying high temperature, the proteins are get clotted, okay, and by high temperature the metabolic enzymes get inactivated, okay, and further heating can also inactivate the enzymes present in the food, and then heating food to high temperature can therefore help to prevent it. Okay, so the specific treatment varies with, okay, there is a specific treatment according to every food, okay, so it depends on the organism that has to be killed, it depends on the food to be preserved, and other means of preservation also may be used in addition to high temperature. Okay, high temperature used for preservation are usually of four types. Okay, so first is pasteurization. It is one of the most ancient methods, as I have told you, and it is invented in 1862. Okay, next is blanching. Blanching and caning are most of these are interrelated. Okay, and if you want to know more about these, I have prepared a separate video for caning, and there you will get a large section about blanching. Okay, so these are mostly interrelated, but we have to study it differently. So blanching is a method to inactivate the enzymes. Okay, and why canning is a process of sealing foodstuffs hermetically in containers and sterilizing them by the heat. Okay, the sterilization process in canning is mostly done by heat treatments. Okay, and then sterilization. Okay, so let us study these four methods in detail. There are many methods, like 1-2 methods there, but they are not that prominent that these are. These are the most important methods that we have to study and the most asked methods. Okay, let us move further. Pasteurization. Okay, so pasteurization frees the food from human pathogens as well as most of the vegetative microorganisms. Okay, so heating of fruit juices, mainly pasteurization applies to some liquid things, okay, liquid food materials like milk is usually pasteurized, and milk is in ancient times in 1862 only milk was pasteurized and all. Okay, so heating of fruit juices ready to serve and nectar is common method for their preservation. Okay, so the process of heating at boiling temperature or slightly below it to or a sufficient length of time to kill microorganisms which cause spoilage is known as pasteurization. Okay, so what is pasteurization? It is a process of heating at boiling temperature and slightly below for a sufficient length of time to kill the microorganisms present in the food item, because mostly we can see microorganisms only by their enzymatic action, by their metabolic activities, they spoil the food. So we have to kill those microorganisms, and for that we boil it, and at a certain temperature pasteurization always occur at below 100 degrees Celsius. Okay, below 100 degrees Celsius, underline it and mark it in your notebooks. Okay, so pasteurization does not kill all microorganisms and juices. Okay, some spores and spores forming bacteria like Bacillus subtilis and Bacillus mesentericus, okay, they can survive in multiple layers, but they cannot, they are too small that they cannot do some spoilage. Okay, and further, these organisms are highly sensitive to acid and cannot grow in juice. Some of the juices have acidic acids in them, like orange have citric acid, and some of the vegetables also have acid in them. So these organisms are highly sensitive to acid. Okay, they cannot grow in the juice of acid fruits and acid vegetables. Okay, so microorganisms can be killed, and some of them are not killed, can be killed by acid. and then even after that some mold spores, okay, mold spores are destroyed by heating at 79 degrees Celsius. Okay, these spores can be destroyed by heating at 79 degrees Celsius for 2 to 5 minutes or 5 to 10 minutes. Okay, so molds require oxygen for their growth. Okay, so what we have learned yet, for killing of microorganisms, we have to boil it. If they aren't killed even after boiling, then acid can kill them. And even after that, we can heat and some of the mold spores are killed at 79 degrees Celsius. And even after that, if they are not killed, some of the microorganisms and some of the mold require oxygen for their growth. And during caning and during the packaging of our fruits and fruit juices and all, we always exhaust them. We just remove the air in them, so there is no oxygen and all for their growth. Okay, so removal of air from the juice by filling containers completely and de-aerating them. Okay. We de-aerate them, there will be no air left within them. So there will be a vacuum created and the air replaces with CO2, okay? So therefore, facilitates the destruction of mold even at a low temperature, okay? So yeah, yeast and acid-tolerant bacteria readily kill if the juice is heated for few minutes at about 66 degrees Celsius. Yeast and all are killed by heating it at, mold spores are killed by heating it at 79 degrees Celsius, okay. Even though some of the bacteria have thermal death time, okay. What is thermal death time? It is the time that it is defined as the time required at a given temperature to kill a stated number of microorganisms under the specific conditions, okay. So like for example, bacteria E. coli, okay. Escherichia coli, everyone have heard of it. It requires 20 to 30 minutes to get destroyed itself at the temperature of 57.3 degrees Celsius. So this bacteria can be killed in 20 to 30 minutes at the temperature of 57 degrees Celsius. Okay. And next is spore forming bacteria. The spore forming bacteria found in tomato juice are however require heating at a temperature, higher temperature of 88 degrees Celsius. Okay. Spore forming bacteria in tomato juice, okay. So enzyme also require oxygen at normal temperature for their action and can therefore be destroyed at a moderate temperature by removing air, okay. So most of the enzymes can be removed only by exhausting the canes, okay. Pectic enzymes are also there in fruits and vegetables, you know, pectic enzymes. We have pectin layer and pectic enzymes in them, okay. So which causes changes in flavor and also bring about clotting of particles in the juice and can be destroyed by heating the juice for about 4 minutes at 85 degrees Celsius, okay. Pectic enzyme can be removed from the fruit juices by heating the fruit juice at 85 degrees Celsius for 4 minutes, okay. Usually juices ready to serve and nectar are pasteurized at 85 degrees Celsius for 25 to 30 minutes, okay. So acid fruit juices require a lower temperature and less time for pasteurization than the less acid ones. Juice can be pasteurized in two ways, okay. There are two ways in which we can pasteurize the juices. First is by heating it at low temperature for a longer period of time, and second is by heating it at higher temperature for a short period of time, okay. Now let us come to the methods of pasteurization. There are three methods of pasteurization. The first one is bottle or holding pasteurization. In this method, it is commonly used for the preservation of fruit juices at home, okay. The extracted juice is strained or clarified as the case may be, okay. So the extracted juice is strained and filled in bottles and then leaving sufficient head space for the expansion of juice during heating. Okay, so the bottles are sealed airtight and pasteurized. How it is pasteurized? What is there in bottle or holding pasteurization? Right, it first method of pasteurization is holding pasteurization. In this method, it is usually an usual method. We can also use it at homes. Like we just strain the juice in a bottle and then just leaving in sufficient head space for the expansion of juice during heating, and then we heat it and it expands to the bottle head, and then we seal it airtightly and it is pasteurized, okay. Now the second method is overflow method. In this method, juice is heated about 2.5 degrees Celsius higher than the pasteurization temperature, okay. So for fruits and juices, the pasteurization temperature is 85 degrees Celsius, okay. So the juices are heated to a temperature about 2.5 degree more than this, okay. So, and then filled in hot sterilized bottles, okay, to the brim, okay. Brim is the bottle head, okay. The juice is filled until the bottle head and the sealed, then they get sealed, okay. So, the sealed bottles are pasteurized at the temperature of 2.5 degree Celsius lower than the filling and sealing temperature, then cooled, okay. Then we fill the in overflow method we fill the juice in 2.5 degree Celsius more temperature than the usual temperature, and then after sealing we again pasteurize it by 2.5 degree Celsius lower temperature than the filling and sealing temperature, okay. So that this method is very suitable for grape juice because it minimizes the adverse effect of air on the quality of juice, okay. Next is flash pasteurization. The juice is heated rapidly to a temperature of about 5.5 degree Celsius higher than the pasteurization temperature, and then kept at this temperature for about a minute, okay. The juice is rapidly heated to a 5.5 degree Celsius higher temperature than the pasteurization temperature, and then it is kept at this temperature for about a minute. And this method has been developed specially for the canning of natural orange juices, but can also be used for grape and apple juices, okay. And it has advantages. It is the most advantageous method of pasteurization, that is I haven't write the name of it, that is flash pasteurization. First is holding, second is overflow, and third is flash pasteurization. Okay, let us see its advantages. It do not lose the flavor, and second is vitamins are not destroyed and affects economy of time and space. And the fourth advantage of it is it keeps the juice uniformly cloudy, and juice is heated uniformly, and cooked taste is minimum. Okay, so let us again revise. In holding, it is the most easy method. We can do it at home, like filling the bottle below the brim and then pasteurizing it, okay. And in overflow, filling the bottle till the brim and pasteurizing it below the, first we pasteurize it about 2.5 degree Celsius from pasteurization temperature, and then below pasteurization temperature 2.5 degree, okay. In flash pasteurization, 5.5 degree higher than pasteurization temperature, and kept at this temperature only, okay. It is the one of the most advantageous methods. So next is sterilization, okay. So sterilization means the destruction of all viable microorganisms, okay. So heat sterilization is one of the most effective process of food preservation. It has a severe effect on heat liable nutrients and particularly vitamins, okay, and mainly through Maillard reaction the nutritional quality of proteins is reduced, okay. So by this method all organisms are completely destroyed due to high temperature, okay. In pasteurization the temperature is below 100 degrees Celsius, but in sterilization the temperature is above 100 degrees Celsius. This is the main difference between both of the prominent methods, okay. The time and temperature necessary for sterilization vary with the type of food, and the fruit and tomato products should be heated at 100 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes so that the spore bacteria which are sensitive to high acidity may be completely killed, okay. And vegetables like green peas, okra and beans, being non-acidic containing more starch than sugar, require high temperature to kill the spore forming organisms, okay. They need high temperature than the fruits and tomato products, okay. Continuous heat for 30 to 90 minutes at 116 degrees Celsius, okay, 116 degrees Celsius is essential for their sterilization for vegetables which are more in starch than sugar, okay. Before using, empty cans and bottles should be sterilized for about 30 minutes by placing them in boiling water. Temperature above 100 degrees Celsius can only obtain by using steam pressure sterilizers. Write it, steam pressure sterilizers. Okay. Such as pressure cookers and autoclaves. The examples of steam pressure sterilizers are pressure cookers and autoclaves. Autoclaves you have also seen in your microbiology labs, okay. A quick technique of aseptic canning, okay. Aseptic canning. aseptic caning using high temperature has also been developed, which not only reduces the sterilization time but also improves the quality of products. Okay, so another methods is like hot pack or hot fill, generally used in homes for preparation of jams and other products. Okay, so aseptic caning, let me give you a brief introduction for aseptic caning. So aseptic caning is nothing more but like, yeah, aseptic caning is a technique in which food is sterilized outside the cans and then aseptically placed in previously sterilized cans, okay, which are subsequently sealed in an aseptic environment. Okay, so the process consists of four aseptic canning process consists of four operations, separate operations carried out one after another. The first process first operation is sterilization of product by appropriate quick heating, okay, then sterilization of containers, then aseptic filling of cooled sterile product into sterile containers, okay, and fourth is aseptic sealing. Okay, so sterilization of product, sterilization of containers, then aseptic filling and aseptic sealing. Okay, these are the four methods of aseptic caning. Now hot packs and hot fill that I have named is these term refers to the filling of previously pasteurized or sterilized food while still hot into clean but not necessarily sterile containers, okay, under clean but not necessarily aseptic conditions. Okay, such packaging is mostly based on the fact that the heat of the food and some holding period before cooling the container render the container commercially sterile. Okay, so for example let's have an easy example of it. Like in home, when fruit pulp and sugar are boiled together to make jams and the hot jams is poured into jars that have been previously boiled, and the principle of hot pack is being employed here in the when the fruit pulp and sugar are boiled together and then poured into jars that are previously boiled. Okay, so the jars are previously boiled, like they are sterile. Okay, so the principle of hot packs is being employed here. Okay, moving further, difference between sterilization and pasteurization. It is the most asked question. So elimination of microbes, let's focus on these points. Okay, elimination of microbes, it is more in sterilization and less in pasteurization. Sterilization eliminates total microbes and pasteurization eliminates some partial microbes. Okay, and then it is processed above 100 degrees Celsius, it is processed below 100 degrees Celsius. Impact on nutritional quality, it impacts nutritional quality more, it impacts nutritional quality less. Okay, then lifetime, it preserves the food for a long time, it preserves the food for short time. It can be stored at room temperature, it cannot be stored at room temperature, it requires refrigerator or low temperature. Next point, blanching. Okay, so blanching is a method of in which let us see this image only. Okay, so in this image you can see some of the vegetables are being boiled and then they are removed outside of the container and then they are immediately put it into the ice. Okay, so our next method is blanching. Okay, so blanching is like to inactivate the enzymes present in the food material. Okay, so it is also known as scalding, parboiling and pre-cooking. Okay, so fruits are generally not blanched, leaving the oxidizing enzyme system active. Some fruit is plunked for a given time from halfway to say like 5 minutes. Okay, so according to variety into water. Okay, so the food or the fruit or vegetable, not fruits, okay, vegetables are immersed in water, boiling water, for like 180 degree to 190 degree Fahrenheit. Okay, so these are boiled at this temperature and then immediately they are cooled by immersion it in cold water or ice water. Okay, so this helps in inactivating degradative enzymes before further processing. Okay, so blanching is an important step in freezing food. Okay, as frozen food can develop flavor, vitamin losses and color changes while in storage. Okay, so let me tell you certain advantages of blanching, that it inactivates most of the plant enzymes which causes toughness and discoloration, for example polyphenol oxidase. Okay, and it reduces the area of leafy vegetables such as spinach by shrinkage or wilting, making their packaging easier. Okay, then it removes tissue gases which reduces sulfides. Okay, it also reduces the number of microorganisms as much as by 99%. Okay, Have you understood this image? It is the most easier explanation, okay? And the boiling temperature is 180 degree Fahrenheit to 190 degree Fahrenheit. Okay, so moving to the next, that is caning. Okay, so caning is the process of sealing foodstuffs hermetically in containers and sterilizing them by heating them for a long period of time. That is heating them and to store them for a long period of time. That is known as caning. Okay, so caning I have only explained the caning in my last lecture, and I am also giving you an overview. Okay, so next is caning. Caning is the process of sealing foodstuffs hermetically in containers and then sealing them by heat. Okay, why do we do caning? Is to preserve that for a long period of time. And yeah, caning is done by higher temperature. Okay, so the principle and processes of caning are so long, and I have prepared a separate video for caning. But for overview, let us discuss the process of caning. That is, first the selection of fruits and vegetables, then grading them, then washing, peeling, and then cutting, and then blanching, as I have told you in previous point. Then cooling, then filling and syruping or brining, exhausting. Via exhausting, as I have told in pasteurization too, via exhausting, there will be no oxygen for the microorganisms to grow. Certain microorganisms are only dependent on oxygen for their growth. If there will be no oxygen, they are automatically being killed. Okay, then sealing, processing, cooling and storage. Okay, so caning also stops any microbial activity. So it is one of the most prominent method of preserving food and widely used modern methods. Okay, so let's see what's written here. It involves the careful preparation of food packed into a sealed tin glass, or okay, temperature is always above 100 degrees Celsius. Okay, so caning prevents the spoilage of food by preventing microorganisms. Okay, that's all.